In this video, we are going to give you the answer of the question, that is why multiplexing. So before going for why multiplexing, let us discuss what is multiplexing. So multiplexing means dividing one link into multiple channels, and that is the main purpose of multiplexing. For the better utilization of bandwidths, multiplexing has been introduced. Multiplexing is a set of techniques that allow the simultaneous transmission of multiple signals across a single data link, and that is the main purpose. Always, you know that multiplexing, this word means that a same thing but having got a maximum or various types of usages. So for the better utilization of the bandwidths, multiplexing has been introduced. So that we can utilize our bandwidth to the fullest extent. Bandwidth, you know, bandwidth means the difference between the maximum frequency and the minimum frequency allowed, that is known as the bandwidth of the media. Multiplexing is a set of techniques that allows the simultaneous transmission of multiple signals across a single data link. Also, whenever the bandwidth of a medium linking two devices is greater than the bandwidth needs of the devices, then the link can be also shared. So just consider this one. Here we are supposed to have only one link here. So here we are having this multiplexer and demultiplexer. In short, it will be called as mux and demux. So multiplexer at the sending end and demux at the receiving end. Here we are having n number of input lines, and this one link will be utilized by for the transmission of n number of channels for n number of input lines, and in the demux we are having n number of output lines. So dividing a link into multiple channels is a respective case for this multiplexing. So let us discuss what are the different categories. So multiplexing mainly divided into main three categories. One, for the frequency division multiplexing, it will be applicable for analog signals. Wavelength division multiplexing for the analog signals, and time division multiplexing for the mainly for the digital signals. So there are three basic multiplexing techniques are there. One is a frequency division multiplexing, in short FDM, wavelength division multiplexing, in short WDM, and time division multiplexing, in short it will be called as TDM. This TDM is having two varieties. One is the synchronous time division multiplexing, another one is a statistical time division multiplexing. So let us each one of them into further details in the following videos. So please watch all of them for the better understanding, and thanks for watching this.
Tutorialspoint.com. Simply easy learning.